Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Screw Attack G1 Wrestling Universe. Tonight we have the G1 Thursday Showdown, and oh boy, howdy, and what a showdown it'll be. Because not only do we have some great matches tonight, but we are on the cusp of the RTX stream event coming up here pretty soon. But what do you say we go ahead and get into the action while I also fill you in on what all is coming here in the near future for your viewing pleasure. Obviously tonight in this first exhibition matchup we have Short Bus Eric versus Tom the Iron Man. Both big men in the G1 community as known as Short Bus makes his way out. Two also big streamers, Tom just in the community as a whole, and Short Bus with a pillar in the G1 Game Days streaming community for pretty much every Wednesday. But what do you say we get on with that info? I can tell you this about the RTX event. There will be ladder matches. There will be table matches. Everything is to the extreme. Well, except for two of the belts. One of the belts that is guaranteed to be up on the line will be the Women's Championship belt. But it's not your everyday match. No, it is actually going to be a triple threat match between the number one contender, Kanan, and another number one contender, G1 Hyper Combo, both going after the belt held by Large Marge. As Short Bus Eric is now in the ring. Also, we do have, like I said, table matches, ladder matches. But there are some stipulations here tonight for what the other two championship matches will be, but we'll get into that later. But also, the ladder match will be between two people that you may know and love in the G1 community who have actually faced off in the ring before and actually have somewhat of a little grudge against each other due to the fact of losing beforehand. Dylan Toomey ain't too happy about losing to the G1 known as Hydro, so he has challenged him, and Hydro has accepted a table match at the RT Extreme match, which should be a delight to see. But also, there is the ladder match, which is actually a Money in the Bank bonus match. There will be six participants, all vying for a case full of money up top of the ring, looking for a bonus in their pay. What they'll spend it on, who knows. But there we now, we have the G1 Tom the Iron Man in the ring. About to get underway this, almost, you could say, battle of the streamers this evening. To start things off. But still, it will be interesting to see what other stipulations may or may not come out of these matches here tonight between everybody, because not only do we have the big championship, the G1 Game Days championship, but also the GSF championship, which has its own possible stipulations as well. Heck, it may not even be put on the line. But again, that's for the future, as the ref has to break up Short Bus and Tom the Iron Man, but Short Bus now in control for the moment. Now shaking around Tom the Iron Man. And, oh, bringing him down to the mat. Still in control. But definitely, obviously, a sight for everybody to see on the RTX is the G1 Hyper Combo and Kanan in that triple threat match that is coming. Definitely be able to see how Large Marge fends off both of those people trying to vie for her belt. As Short Bus Eric still in control, gotten Tom the Iron Man against the ropes. Irish whip. Oh, but Tom dodges it. Now in control with Short Bus up against the rope with an Irish whip of his own. Picks him up and very easily showing that power of Tom the Iron Man, but it's a reversal to gain that momentum back. And now what Short Bus did? Oh, he's taking him outside. Can definitely do some damage now. Oh, looks like Short Bus giving him a mouthful on the outside. But Tom dodging those right hands, but he manages to nail him with that drop kick. But there, it's a reversal, and now you can hear that count going on. They both will be counted out with the reversal there if they don't hurry up and get back in the ring. Oh, just trading reversals. There we go. Now it looks like they hear that count. They're getting back in the ring at the count of six. Short bus with a big body slam on Tom the Iron Man. Looks like moving him into position, going for a cover now. There we go. Obviously, some respect between these two for being streamers in the G1 community, but obviously no love loss here as we've seen in the ring. Oh, what's this? Oh, the short bus showstopper right now. Okay, that's it. There we go. Is he going to go for a cover? Yes, he is. What's he going to get? One, two, and the Iron Man kicks out of that. Short bus can't quite believe it, but there we go. Back up again with Tom on the offensive. Oh, big takedown by Tom the Iron Man. Now going to work on that leg and knee of Short Bus. Tom has definitely gained some momentum here. Oh, what's he doing now? Oh, my goodness. Easily just throwing Short Bus. And there's a elbow drop. Definitely has Short Bus on the defensive now. Needs to do something. Oh, my goodness. Big over-the-head body slam by what's... Oh, no. Oh, no. There's the iron press suplexes there. This might be it for Short Bus as he goes for a cover. One. Oh! Kicks out right at two, and Tom can't quite believe it, which is fully understandable. Those iron press suplexes can take a lot out of you. As Short Bus is now on the ropes as Tom throws him onto the side of the mat. He manages to hang on. The Short Bus goes to grab him, hops back in the ring as Tom gets out. Now playing a little bit of cat and a mouse as both men make their way back in the ring. Now Tom with an Irish whip, now finally taking Short Bus onto the side of the ring again. But Short Bus with a reversal, hopping easily back in the ring right on top of Tom. Oh, what's he doing now? Oh, my goodness. Now it looks like Short Bus is in command with that big kick to the... Uh-oh, what's he doing now? Oh, but no, it's got a reversed by Tom, the Iron Man, who's now gained back that lost offensive. Throwing Short Bus into the corner with a big kick, bringing him down to the bottom rope now. Now shoving his foot right into the chest of Short Bus. Over the shoulder reversal by Short Bus. Both bends have the power and the technique to give each other a definite fight as now Tom goes to the work on the neck and head of Short Bus there. And now throwing him down to the mat. There with a big right. But no, again, reversed by Short Bus. Definitely not taking this fight lying down. That's for darn sure as he throws Tom into side of the ring. Uh-oh, looks like he's going outside now. Oh, no. Tearing up that official's table. But it looks like Tom sees what he's doing. He's on the outside, but and it's Short Bus saw him, but it was reversed as Tom picks him up. Oh, drops him right on his knee for a big gut buster on the outside. Uh-oh. And now a backbreaker. Both sides have seen Tom's knee and have paid for their indiscretion as Tom goes back in the ring now to avoid being count out. Short Bus a little dazed and confused on the outside of the ring. Makes his way back in just in time. Short Bus with an Irish whip on Tom. Picks him up. Oh, catches him. What is this? Oh, flips him onto his shoulder. Oh, my goodness. An extreme show of power. Goes with the cover. Two, three. Oh, my goodness. Out of nowhere. Oh, I bet you Tom's not happy about that. That's for darn sure. I know I wouldn't be. As we see here, this amazing move with the slam down, got coming back in the ring from Short Bus. Obviously taking its toll. On the Iron Man. But it's not like the Iron Man weren't without his good moves, as seen here. With these iron press slams. And of course, as we see here, seemingly almost out of nowhere, incredible feat of strength by Short Bus. Just picking him up, heaving, hoeing him down, bringing him to the mat. Obviously caught Iron Man off guard. Was able to get the 1-2-3. Amazing win by Short Bus. Though the Iron Man may not be finished with him yet, I would not doubt that. But again, that's not all that we have for you this evening. We still have more matches with more stipulations coming up right now. Here we go. Here's our first stipulation match of the evening with Solid Snake, the belt holder versus Renegade. As you may know, Solid Snake is the current G1 Game Days champ, with Renegade vying for their title shot in the upcoming RTX, which is already set on paper. This will determine the type of match. Now, Renegade has said that he does have somebody in his corner that can come and help him if need be. So, the outcome of this match will determine whether or not this will be the upcoming title match, will be a regular match or a hardcore falls count anywhere, no disqualification type match. Because Renegade obviously has a plan to finally snatch that belt away, but Solid Snake, being the champion he is, has decided the stipulation should be fought out in the ring, which will be here in a moment as the champ makes his way down to the ring now, getting ready to come into the ring. Basically, if Solid Snake happens to win this evening, it will be a regular match. 1-2-3 inside the ring, winner take all. Whereas if Renegade happens to win the day, then it will be a all-out war in the ring, which I'm sure Renegade wants, especially with that stipulation that he has somebody on his side that would help him get that belt, which obviously the champ does not want to happen. Because the champ is obviously very, very aware of his abilities and knows that, champ as he may be, it is definitely easier with a one-on-one match than a two or possibly three-on-one match. Now, as Renegade makes his way to the ring, slowly but surely, it's all on the line whether or not whose plan will be thwarted or who will win this upcoming pay-per-view event for all the marbles. because Renegade has showed in the past that he has what it takes to take the fight out of Solid Snake, the same as Solid Snake has what it takes to win. And that all comes down to this evening on the eve of the RTX event. Now, obviously, this is just a regular singular 1-2-3 in the middle of the ring match as we get things underway. Though I wouldn't be surprised if some countouts take a little bit longer than they probably should as they both wrap up there. The official has to get them off of each other, which I don't blame them. And they wrapped up again now. It looks like Solid Snake. Renegade up against the ropes this time. Looks like the official has to break him up again. Definite. Oh, but Renegade now. Definitely showing some frustration and anger with Solid Snake. Definitely wants the stipulations to go his way, that's for certain. Tip the odds in his favor, but no, there's a takedown by Solid Snake into a headlock. And oh, there's a big knee to the back. Right hand now with the Irish whip. Oh, a big clothesline by Solid Snake. Now just stomping repeatedly Renegade as Renegade makes his way back up as quickly as he can. Oh, what's this? Oh, but it's reversed by Renegade. Now picks him up, brings him down with a backbreaker, stretching that back out over his knee for maximum damage. Renegade now setting him up. Oh, with a big stomp on the arm. Because part of me wants to actually see what happens if Renegade gets this. See exactly what would happen in this extreme fight. What would actually come to play? Who would he possibly bring down to the ring with him? Because with so many people in his stable, who exactly is on his side that could possibly want to get that belt away from Solid Snake? It could be anybody up at this point. And there, Renegade fires back with chops and kicks and punches, bringing down the champ. Now stomping on his back. But Solid Snake back up, reverses it. Irish whips him onto the side of the ring, knocking him down back to the floor. Taking things to the outside. What are we going to get out here? Solid Snake in control. Oh, bringing him back down to the mat with that big move there. No one stomps on to Renegade and kicks. Tell you what, those pads out there look nice and fluffy to break your fall, but they are not. Because underneath those mats are cold, hard concrete, and it hurts. There we go, the count going up. Renegade, dazed and confused, hurry up and gets back into the ring himself. The big kick, Renegade up on top with Solid Snake up against the ropes now. Oh, big forearms to the back, bouncing him off those rings, bringing him down to the mat. Oh, big uppercut by Solid Snake. Oh, what's he doing? Not rolling him up. It's a fake roll up into that super kick. Okay, one, two. Oh, he grabbed the ring. No, the official didn't see it. He grabbed that rope. The official did not see it. Got the three count. Oh, if I was Renegade, I would not be happy. So you see that big uppercut into that fake roll-up super kick, bringing him down. Goes for the... And there goes. The official does not see it. Rings the bell. Renegade will not be happy. But Solid Snake wins. Things will go his way at the RTX event. So whatever plans he has. Oh. Looks like it will be off or not. And here we go with the next stipulation match of the evening. Both men agreeing to the terms there in the center of the ring. This match stipulation is at MESAC doesn't actually believe Barrel deserves a shot at the working man's title. So, in this match, Barrel pretty much has to prove himself the number one contender to get a match at the Extreme Rules for the GSF belt. Because as MESAC put it, you have to make me believe. I worked unbelievably to get this belt. So, make me believe. If you have to, make me bleed. I believe is what the man said. So, Barrel has to put on an incredible match. I guess the stipulation is to make him bleed. I'm not sure, but... because he didn't say he had to win, just prove that he could work hard enough to get the belt. He misses with that super kick. Now Barrel being thrown on the outside by the champ. Misses with that kick, just barely lands that one. Now with big left, right drop kick now, bringing Barrel down. Not having a good showing so far. Definitely needs to get the upper hand somehow, some way. Oh, now taken down via the leg. At this rate, he may not end up being the number one contender. If he does not turn this around, the GSF belt may not go and be up on the line. There's MESAC says, giving him a mouthful of why he's outside. What are you doing outside? I was in the ring. When actually he was the one that put Barrel out there in the first place. But now the action is inside the ring as Barrel now has a moment of control. Now throwing MESAC outside of the ring. Looks like he's waiting for him to get up. Decided to go outside the ring to meet him. Now with his own leg takedown on the champ, we might be seeing the beginning of a comeback here for Barrel. But no, a big forearm reversal by MESAC. Now with kicks to the back. Now, throwing him into the side of the ring. The champ showing no mercy. Definitely wanting to get the best out of Barrel that he can. Now going back in the ring before that countout goes anywhere. And there we see that swift roundhouse kick from Barrel Dragon, bringing down the champ. But no, big elbow reversal to get him out of that, but Barrel still on top of the champ. And no, another reversal. Barrel big super kick, bringing down Barrel Dragon. This ain't going to be good. Here we go, cover. One, two, but no, Barrel kicks out. Big super kick. MESAC can't believe it. Barrel fighting with everything that he has. Big drop kick by Barrel, bringing down the champ. Now Barrel going to work on MESAC's head and neck. Looks like he's trying to twist it off. There, he throws him down to the mat. Barrel now going outside. What's he doing now? Looks like he's tearing up the official table. We just put that back together. From the last match, he's tearing it right back up. MESAC is ready for him, though, right there. But no, Barrel grabs control. What's he doing? He's got MESAC up against that. He's setting him on the table. This ain't going to be good. This might be it for MESAC. Right through the table. MESAC has went through the official's table by ringside. Crowd chanting that this is awesome as MESAC is dazed and confused outside. Now Barrel, my goodness! Those dragon kicks by Barrel. Goes for a cover. One, two, gets a two count. My goodness. It looks like those dragon kicks from Barrel have split open MESAC. After being put through the table, he still manages to kick out of a two. At two, after all of that, that is why he is the GSF champ. Barrel now giving his all, putting him up on the top rope. What's he got plans for MESAC now? Picking him up. Oh, my goodness. Oh, that hurt both of them. As you can see there, a barrel quickly turning him over, going for another pin. Smart man going two. Oh, barely kicks out at two. Looks like he has definitely given it his all. Busted the man open, put him through a table. And now bringing him down to the mat with a reversal. The champ now has a moment of control. Oh, with a quick elbow drop. Oh! Oh, no. Got that leg lock held in. Will barrel tap? Will barrel tap out? Will he have to release? Nah, he releases him. He's out of it. He manages to get a reversal. Oh, tries to go for that. But no, what's it? Oh! Brainbuster on barrel. Goes for a roll-up. Two. Barely a two count. Barrel slowly makes his way to his feet. Same with Misak. Both have definitely been put through their... Oh! Bringing down Barrel hard there. No, oh, no. What's he doing now? Misak on the top rope. Oh, it looks like he's waiting for Barrel to get up. Don't get up, Barrel. Don't do it. Oh, there he goes. Oh, the flip. Bringing down Barrel. Let's see that. Oh! Now both men are down. Still down in the ring. If they don't hurry up and get up, they'll both be counted out. Nobody will win. Oh, okay, it looks like Barrel's getting ready to stir. Oh, the champ, he goes to get up. Is he going to get a pin? No, Barrel, he's making his way up. Okay, both men back to their feet. Oh, but the champ now has Barrel. Oh, suplex. Bringing down Barrel. Looks like Misak is firmly in control at the moment. Catching his breath as Barrel slowly makes his way, climbing up the ropes to his feet. Oh, and there's a big super kick. Champ still deciding what to do, catching his breath. Oh, it looks like he's decided. He's on the move. And oh, but no, Barrel gets a quick kick in. Oh, there's that roundhouse again. Bringing down Misak. Wasn't quite ready for that. As Barrel has a moment of control in this match. Barrel now having him. Oh, flips him over. Oh, rolls him up. One, two, oh, almost a three count. He manages to wiggle his way out of it. And that's why he is the champ. But no, quickly. Oh, what's this? Oh, my goodness. He goes quickly for a pin up. There, two, three. That does it. But will that be enough for Barrel to get the shot at Extreme Rules? As we go over these replays, as Misak figures out what he's going to do. Will he name him the number one contender for the Working Man's GSF title? You see that big reversal there. And super kick bringing down Barrel. But here we saw an amazing effort by Barrel to take out the champ on that official's table on the outside. Amazing display of strength as he whips him right over, right through that table. And there we see that incredible roll-up showing the amazing agility of Barrel, but only getting the two count. But the champ quickly retaliates, bringing him down and quickly covers him for a 1-2-3, as you can see, right in the middle of the ring. Now let's see what's going to happen as he celebrates. Will he give Barrel the number one contender spot? Will it happen? As you can see him there bleeding after the beating that Barrel gave him. So what'll it be? Will he get it? Yes! The result is he is the new number one contender. He will get his shot at the RT Extreme Rules. And that'll do it for us today, people. Until next time.